Yes, welcome back to Let's Talk About It, a podcast for the youth created by the youth. I go by the name of Anna Sharma and I'm hosting today's podcast. And on the panel we have...
Show. Should we stay show? You saying though?
Zeta.
There you go. So we are here today and we are talking about another topic. Now, today's topic, big one, it's about drugs. Drugs in youth. How does drugs affect the youth? Why do youth take drugs? You know what I'm saying?
Drugs.
So, like, we're going into it, this one.
Yes.
So, guys.
Drugs,
let's
weed.
Let's speak
crack,
about drugs.
Cocaine.
All of them.
Promethazine, lean.
So, why do we think, drugs is such a big thing within young people?
Shall I start?
Go ahead.
So, obviously, when we were talking about our mental health podcast, like, previously, we were talking about how young people kind of use drugs to kind of escape their problems and it's just an easy way out. I think that's like one of the biggest reasons. And then another reason would probably be peer pressure or like the glorification of it in today's society.
So, look, I'm going to keep it real, innit? I'm going to keep it very real. Yes, people are taking drugs to numb the pain and stuff, but I think majoritively people are taking the drugs just to fit in. Like, because they see other people taking drugs and you're seeing all your favourite rappers taking drugs, you're going to want to take drugs to fit in. Allow it, man, that's dead. I'll be real. But do you know what? I don't want to start off so with so much vim to get it, but I'm just coming out there where I don't want to hear, I want to hear everyone's opinions and stuff, but I don't want to beat around the bush. Just let them know, like, I personally think people are out here taking drugs to fit in, which is dead, which is probably the worst thing you can do, anything. Don't ever do something that's not you, do you get it?
Yeah.
But yeah, so go on, what else do you guys think?
With drugs, there's just different levels. Because you've got your drugs that, you know, your class A, your class B, you know what I'm saying?
Mm. What is class B?
So class B is weed.
I thought that was class A.
No.
Class A is like your hard drugs. Like
hard drugs,
cocaine, crack, your
cocaine,
and heroines,
meth,
and all of that stuff.
Yeah, I mean,
that's the mad stuff.
Yeah, yeah, but you got the people that are really going through some stuff, like they're like addicts, and then you got your, you know what I mean, your lifestylers, you know what I mean, the people who want to flex, do you know what I mean, get lit. Like, in a sense, even, bro, I think alcohol is a drug. Obviously, it's legal.
Yeah.
But it's
alcohol a drug. Alcohol is a drug.
Bro, it's a drug at the end of the day. Do you get what I'm saying?
Cigarettes is a drug.
Cigarettes is a drug.
Nicotine.
Yeah.
But then, really, we're like, it's like when you think about it, like, why do people smoke, for example, to relieve stress? Some people actually need to relieve stress. You had a hard day at work, you want to ease your mind, like you got 1,001 things. You know what? Let me just light a cig. You know what I mean? For a moment, let me just light a zubi. Then you start
for
smoking.
For people that don't know what a zubi means, it's like a spliff.
So let me light a spliff. Let me just ease my mind. Then sometimes it's not enough. You start to delve in more. Okay, let me grab some flavors. So now this is a different strain of weed. So now you're getting more
stronger
into it. Stronger, do you get what I mean? And then on top of that, you're listening, you're hearing things, do you get what I mean? You're listening to music, you're bro, like your friends are telling you, oh, hey, bro, it's lit, try this, man, have a bit of this, do you get what I'm saying? Like, also, again, if I feel like a lot of things in the UK are influenced from America, we don't like to admit, and we all, as like people from the UK, we have our own things, but a lot of things are influenced from the UK, so do you get what I'm saying? You're seeing all of this and you're thinking, let me just try it. Like, what's there to lose? Do you get what I'm saying?
You only live once, like, why not try it?
But you want to live for a long time, so don't try it.
But like a lot of young people.
Yeah, I'm not advising anyone to go ahead and take it.
We're not trying to encourage nothing.
Do you get what I'm saying?
In fact, I hope you can stop doing this stuff.
Because it is dumb.
It does. And then obviously I want to go about what you said as well, Johnny. Like, for example, you said you've got the lifestylers and then you've got the addicts, Personally, why I don't agree with that, is because these lifestylers turn into addicts. Do you get it? They start off like, let's be real, like, we all know someone that smokes weed. Yeah, we all do. Like, that's actually become a very big norm nowadays, isn't it? But then there's people that I know that are smoking weed every single day and they're trying to tell me they're not addicted. Yeah, it doesn't make sense, you get it? And then I'm there trying to tell you're addicted, but they don't see it. Like an addict, they don't know they're addicted. Do you get it? Like, it's just mad. It's just a whole mad topic. So do you know what? Yeah, I want to make this one very personal, innit? So we're gonna go around and share our own experience with drugs kind of thing, innit? Because I feel like we need to keep it very personal and people need to understand. So I'll be real, I'll go first. Yes, I smoked weed before. I have smoked marijuana before. It's like growing up where I am, friends with who I'm friends with, it's there, it's very accessible.
It's in your environment, isn't it? You're going
to
do it.
Yeah. Where I go to a party, where I'm just hanging out with my boys, it's there kind of thing. So yes, I've done it before. Now, I'll be real. And remember how I called people out doing it to fit in? I was that guy. Do you get it? I was doing it because my boys are doing it. It's cool. Let me just do it kind of thing. I hated being high. Like, I hate it. I need to know where I'm going. Like, I need to know. Like, for me, when I'm seeing two things walking down the street, I just don't like it. It just doesn't make any sense to me. I hated that feeling. Do you get it? So... And then I just hated being high, but I just kept on doing it because I was just fitting in and this and that, this and that. And then I just thought, you know what, this is all dead kind of thing. So then I dropped it. I said, no, I'm never smoking it again. And since then, I remember 1st of January, 19, never done it again since then, kind of that and alcohol. Because it's just that, it didn't make sense. They both tasted disgusting. They both made me feel off. So I just thought, yeah, just forget. Mm-hmm. Why am I doing it? I don't need to kill myself to fit in. And then I realised that I can still fit in without doing that stuff. So that's what I'm trying to say. If you're only doing it to fit in, allow it. Do you get it? Like, it's just not needed. You're just harming yourself.
True.
But yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Zia, what's your personal experience with drugs?
Cool. See, my personal experience is, it's a bit tropical. Mm. So like, okay, cool. So tropical. Obviously like...
That's a mad word.
Tropical.
Okay, cool. So like, obviously I've done things like...
What things?
Like alcohol, weed. A little bit of codeine. But that's just about it. But let me go into it, yeah, cool. So when I was younger, everyone was bunning. Literally like my neighbours, my whole street,
How old are you for the viewers?
I'm 17 right now. I'm turning 18 in a month. Everybody was kind of doing it around me, innit? I never really knew what it was until like I hit secondary school. And I think like in year 10, especially since like where I live, you just smell it everywhere, literally. So like that nice smell, whatever, so cool. So I was one of them people in school that was like very like vivacious. Like I always want to like try new things. I like to do new things and stuff like that. So obviously I was a leader, not a follower. So I was like, come, let's all jump on it. So we jumped on weed now. Cool. And weed, I hated being high, like I hated it. But then obviously I just wanted to kind of stress relief, but I hated the feeling of being high. Like I would reach a low point and then I would smoke or like I'll take an edible and then when I'm high, I'll be like, why the hell did I do this to myself? I hate this feeling. Like, it's like I had control in it. Like I could, if I was somewhere far, I could find my way home. It wasn't a thing where I didn't know where I was. I was seeing two things. I just hated like when I was taking it and I was just hearing bare voices in my head. But it's my own voice telling me, why did I do this? Why did I do this? So it's just like a guilty conscience in a way, but I hated it. Like, and then since then, I've just kept hearing shit in my head, so I just cut it off. And then especially since one time I had a bad edible in school and I had a bad high, and then basically I bugged out in school, everyone videoed it, and it was so bad. Like, I was literally crying to my head teacher. No, I ran to her and I was crying. I was like, Miss, I feel sick. She didn't know I was high at the time. And bear in mind, I was head girl at the time as well. So I could have lost that. I could have been kicked out and everything.
Head girl.
So it was like, it was a bad experience. And like that, the feeling of being high on them edibles, that didn't leave my body until weeks. So I just knew, from that day, I never took, I'd never smoked, never done anything ever again. It wasn't even,
that's
it's
the
not
thing.
Cute.
Everyone has a different, it affects it was, everyone differently.
I
like,
hated it.
I know a guy, who's cool, calm, brother, loved going out, doing everything, he started chilling around some guys, smoking some stuff. Bro, the guy ain't the same no more. When I look in his eye, it's like nothing's going through. Do you get what I'm saying, fam?
And bear in mind, I was doing it for like a year straight. Mm. So, and that was just horrible, innit? So I'm glad I cut it off. And like, it's sad to see that like some of my friends ain't cut it off. Like some of my friends are footballers. Mm. Some of my friends like have like so much going for them, but they the minute they started smoking weed, yeah, everything went downhill for them.
Yeah, it's
like,
mad, it's mad, it's mad.
And they just
mad.
Waste their money on it as well.
But yeah, that's definitely, I was going to touch on that, but obviously, let's see, Johnny. Johnny, what's your personal experience?
Me, me, I won't even lie. Ganja, nah, I've smoked. Sometimes I still get caught up in it. Like with me, it's a thing of where, it's just stress. Like, and I can't lie, the high for me, like it was all right. It was all right. It's just it's settling. Do you get what I'm saying? It's settling. I've been around people who smoke different stuff, like different things, and like you take a hit of it. Like, come, bro, just take
Cali flavors,
and you're just like flavors. Take a pull, bro. You're like, oh, let me see what it's the same.
It
bro.
All feels the same though.
It's, you hit it now. You're on cloud nine. You're just thinking, oh. This is new, do you get what I'm saying? Mm. But you, as I said before, it affects people differently. So you can't get lost. Some people can handle it. Other people can't handle it. 100%. The same with alcohol. Like, what's your drink? Like, handle your drink. Like, when people say handle your drink, that is not a joke. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah, handle
like,
your drink.
Some people drink. Next thing you know, boom, like, they're flatlined. Like, they're done. Do you get what I'm saying?
I feel like it just has an... it triggers your emotions. That when you're at your lowest, that's when it's kind of... And especially
yeah,
since
you,
so
some people get to uplift
well,
you
like,
and that, yeah.
But yeah, but even like codeine, like when I done that, yeah, that was it cool. I didn't like the taste of alcohol, but alcohol is just like, especially since I'm African, yeah, it's just, you know, it's everywhere, innit? Mm. But I didn't really like, I don't like the taste. But when I did codeine, I like the taste.
No, sweet.
Yeah,
the
yeah,
codeine.
Yeah,
I can't lie. With the codeine
like
thing,
the taste.
Yeah.
And it was a nice high, but it was just really bad. Like, that could really
it fucks
kill
with your belly
you,
and that,
like,
you know? Because really and truly, it's medicine. Do you get it? Like,
so then
it's
I
actual
just,
medicine. You're not
and then someone told me,
that.
Yeah, that it's like liquid crack. And then I was like, what? And then I just, no.
Listen, there's mad drugs out in this world,
that.
Man. There's mad drugs out in
Before
this world.
Before you
carefully.
Even take it, do your research. Because you know what,
just
yeah.
Not even do your research. Just don't take it. Like, there's actually no benefits to these things. I'll be real, there's no benefits.
You can sit here and say don't take it, but then there's the, like, ah, cool. Let's let's go like, upper class now. Let's talk crack, cocaine, heroin, all of these things. Like now, like people are taking these things. People are like certain men know people serving. Like, do you get what I mean? People have friends. You're doing what you're doing. Do you get what I mean? You're out on the roads. You're pushing weight. Yeah, and like you like these are affecting people's lives differently. It's not a thing of where it's a choice now. Mm. I have to have the drug. Like I need this. I need like, do you get what I'm saying? Like some people it's in their bloodstream. So it's with so that, like seek help. Like obviously I'd say seek help. It's just the effects
man.
It has on people is crazy.
100%, man. Go to Drugs Anonymous or something like that.
Yeah, like even when like my friends that still smoke weed now, yeah, like I'm telling them stop it because it's going to like cause long-term. Like you think it's making you feel good now, yeah, but it's going to cause long-term illnesses. Yeah. Like weed can, people think weed is harmless, cool, it helps cure diseases and whatever, but you're not deep in that. It can make you get schizophrenia.
Yeah,
like,
it's true. It's
and
true.
That's one thing. That's why I was just like, from when I just started realizing I'm hearing shit in my head, I was like, yep, I'm cutting that off. And then I knew, yeah, like that shit can actually make you schizophrenic. Like.
And that's one thing that I want to touch on anyway, just before we end this episode. I wanted to make sure we do speak about how drugs and mental health coincide. Like, not necessarily having mental health, you need drugs, but how drugs can cause mental health. Mm-hmm. So, stuff like, for example, like you said, schizophrenia. Like, I know someone who has, who was just, Like Johnny said, a normal person, normal guy. I used to chill with the guys. We used to go out this and that. He's hanging out with the wrong people who might not be smoking what he thinks he's smoking, smoking a mad thing. And then he's just gone off the rails. You get it? He's gone. Literally. And then now that I see him, you can just look at them in their face. They're not the same guy anymore.
Vegetable,
like. You get it? It's
have
insane.
Have you seen
vegetable.
That show? Yeah, it's called Soft White Underbelly. And it's like about people... It's like about drug addicts, yeah? Mm. And they're still on the drugs, but they're telling you their experiences and their stories and like how they got onto
it. Oh, I saw something like that.
And then they even brought this one woman.
The woman, yeah, I saw the woman. That's
what
I saw.
She's been on 3 episodes, innit? And every time you see her, it's only like a couple
months
apart. She gets worse to the point. Yeah. She can't even speak anymore. Yeah. Like, it's so sad.
People don't realize how bad they're getting until they get their kind of thing. It's just mad. It's just mad. Literally, but guys, literally, if you have experienced anything that we've spoken about, about on this episode, please go seek some help. Go speak to someone. Go to Drugs Anonymous. Avoid the drugs, man. If you see people smoking it, just avoid it. It's not needed at all. Alcohol, if you're going to drink, then obviously drink with your own limits. But we are telling you guys not to. We're not condoning drugs at all. So make sure you get some help and keep, and just stop. Like, just stop at the end of the day. Just stop. You don't need it in your life. So there's no point in having it. But that is the end of this episode. And make sure you lot are here next time to see what else we talk about.